Same thing with Immortals. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys so much for waiting. Thank you so much for hearing us vamp, because now we're finally into the second semifinals between Immortals and Sentinels. Immortals, they're looking for the upset. Sentinels, they want to maintain their spot in top 3 NA.
They want that heavy seeding if they possibly can, and it begins with a bang, not a whimper, that's for sure. We've already traded blows back and forth as Immortals have lost. Now Chemical is a player that I was hyping up so much, but, you know, at the same time, it's a little bit rough for Sentinels because they have lost now Raze, and obviously Sinatra is an absolute masterclass. He just shows everybody how to do it in a textbook fashion. Now Dapper has been taken out for good measure, and Sentinels, they're being knocked down a couple of pegs as they're looking to push towards A.
Shazam still around the corner waiting for players to try to rotate in, but instead, both Nature and JC Stanny, who are waiting up on the A site, they end up getting exposed. So there you go. Sentinels now left with only a singular person, still sick. And he has a whole lot of routes to go through. Still, the B site is going to be fully his. So welcome to the Sova Show. I want to see if he has any cheeky lineups or anything of the sort, but we're not going to see too much of that going into this round. Instead, he has to hold on to his guns, hold on to his britches, because this one is going to be quite entertaining. Still the 2v1. I think Gangsta is the only one with low HP, but...
But he has a dart.
Does have the dart. Does have at least recon, and ooh... Okay, at least just a far one. That was just a straight shot. No bounce, nothing of the sort. Still fairly simple, but in we go. He's about to get revealed by that potentially. No, he's not. He's right behind the wall and just waiting up with the owl drone at the perfect time too. Well done. In they go. Still the defuse going down for shot up. And Sick can't get the headshot in the end. If there's anything that Sick can do, it's absolutely heavily in their favor. Sentinels really does want to commit to this purely because of the positions that we see, especially
what?
From shot up. There you go. He gets that first frag. No way he doesn't get traded, right? You think. But the dismiss gets him out of there. Almost gets himself the second, but Zoms is going absolutely nuts. And Sick is there to return the frag back. Sentinels against Immortals' his best chance to really rack on a couple of rounds. They're knocking them down to only two players remaining. Again, they can't exactly do much. They're still peeking around the corner. That's, well, that turret with Sinatra at an extreme off angle. Can't do much with it. Gangsta now in a 1v4. His goal now would were to be, I guess, a couple of exits, but I think everyone from Sentinels might just be running in a little bit. But they fully spot this one out. Good headshot from Gangsta. He's chilling out, though.
He does have a dart.
He's
maybe
literally in that
frag.
Same position. Yeah. More than confident. Still has so many angles to actually look at as he's still in a two-man setup, with his teammate actually being fairly conservative on sights.
He heard that.
He certainly did, but against Sentinels, they've always been in that back line anyways, and Shot Up knows this. Just so happens to be that he has such a great opportunity, but Sinatra takes him down immediately. Shot Up misses his first opportunity for the frag, and what I said before with the confidence, that seeped away. Still Immortals with a man advantage. Gangsta takes it back.
Paranoia.
And JC Stanny, beautiful position. Gonna be able to take that one. Still the smoke can't get it, but he readjusts for the third.
That's huge.
Huge for JC.
Sentinels will up the pace. They have the ultimates if they get that spike down, and that'll make things a lot more palatable. So look for that spike to go down ASAP.
And
actually, right on cue. There it is.
Yeah, there you go. Zom just rushes his way on site, but still, JC Stanny has been in this position for a while. Sinatra was about to go down, but JC Stanny couldn't take him down. So even then, the showstopper hits. Shazam still gets a kill back onto Nature. That was a little bit off-angly. But even then, Chemical's on the front lines. Still has at least the op-out. The right clicks with the classic doesn't work out in this favor. But Shut Up with both players at off-angles. The Hunter's Fury going in. Still down a half. Sick might be in such a tricky scenario now. And even with next click, the defuse will go in. That is more than theirs, but still now with the rifles back and Immortals with their economy a little bit more damaged, there could be a massive opportunity. But Gangsta actually shuts down Dapper early. That's a big frag, but Shazam gets one back too. It's a 4v4 now, Ito.
Sentinels made that one incredibly close for what they had to work with. They blew a couple of ultimates for it. They don't have that Hunter Sphere as well as a Showstopper in play. And if Immortals get that Killjoy lockdown up pretty soon, that could be a tool that otherwise, not wasted, but it could have been used to take down the lockdown. I mean, really, the stocks for that lockdown become way more valuable. So look for that to try to come into play soon. But for now, like you said, they've stayed even so far. I think perhaps the best move for them to be, or would be, sending it B like they are right now, but keep an eye on Zombs. That late lurk, I think, is going to be absolutely round-changing. He's not even going to be in that position. He's just going to help out for the fight. Toss out a smoke. It's going to be a really one-track-minded sort of push. It doesn't seem to actually hurt Sentinels anymore, though. They find the opening kill. They're fine with it anyway.
Like I said, Shazam, he takes up so much space in such little time. He's more interactive in a sense that you would expect off of swings, and he definitely proves it. Still going for that first contact, clearing up more line of sight, as now Sentinels, they're still running out of time to actually get that plant down with, again, the Nano Swarm just chipping away so much damage. Still ganks in the back lines, and wow, Shazam! The 1-2 combo, but Shadow turns it down! No time! 29 seconds left! He needs to run! Oh! But Shazam shuts it down with milliseconds left!
Because I think it's not going to be something that's limited to that one round only. Sentinels, although they've dropped the player, they've quickly evened things up here, and this is why I wasn't worried. The resilience from Sentinels is so absurd. They've not only eked out one more kill, but had a chance to get another one too. Now JC Stanny is threatening that plant from potentially going down. Shazam doesn't have his teammates back covered, and that's actually really gonna hurt. They do get the spike planted, which is great news, and Shazam does hit a banger, but it'll still all come down to Sinatra to hold the line. It's not gonna work out, so everything that I was praising for Sentinels in the past doesn't seem to come to fruition right here. But the reason why that happened
on that scopes rifle thus far, and I don't doubt him at this point, although his economy goes down incredibly low, he has nothing to lose and all the frags to gain. He gets himself one back onto Shut Up, and even then Sentinels off that first pick, they're still looking to go quick. JC Stanny with the teleport back, although he is getting pinged out. 8 HP, and this man has almost no chance. That nade catches him off, and now, still, Immortals. Over towards the back of site. The rotation has been fully made. No ultimates at this point, because here's the thing. Sentinels still has full control of this site, but they're playing so aggressively, Ito. How is this working out for the boys of Immortals? But Dapper, he's going to be able to get chemicals, who tried to get a little bit spicy with the op. And even then, Nature now in a 1v2, going to be able to catch one. Still one up top. Shazam, he won out at least one of these rounds with a clutch. He could do it again. But Nature, good call out. And Shazam gets taken down. Immortals, I mean, at least carry it out now. Ooh, as now
that's
Sentinels.
That's good by chemicals.
I mean, that's great by chemicals, but he had such a good spot early on to potentially get himself a frag to open up that B main area. But again, Sentinels, they're just playing this play by play. And already with 120 left in the round, you have three players going down as Zombs takes down JC Stanny.
Do have some pretty powerful ultimates, though. That Hunter Sphere, I'm wondering if we're going to be seeing it used to try to deny plant. Or, I mean, there's so many ways to use this Hunter's Fury, it's impossible to track down the one that they're going to try to go with. Ultimate use for info is also important to mention. Sentinels, they don't even seem fully dedicated to this idea of going B, but now after getting that amazing kill from Shot Up, I think they've become a little bit more convinced. Hunter's Fury will indeed come through, not to deny plant, but just to deny them space. But it's not going to work. Shock Dart will go out, this one actually to deny the plant. But it's a 1v4 that Gangsta will have to pull off, and I'm pretty sure here that we're looking at 7-5. I know you were thinking about maybe the Sentinels playbook, but right now all I can keep my eye on is the fact that there's a Sheriff in play, and they'll be taken out before there's actually any used. Immortals, they're just stomping, man. This is exactly like yesterday. Such a clean execute from the Immortal side.
And again, let me remind you, it's rare to see Sentinels even lose out on this map, although
the Dapper is in such just a far off isolated position where it's just a matter of time before he gets overwhelmed. This is Immortals now trying to extend for as much control as they can. They've already gotten the spike down. Go for a little
for Immortals to go take, but with the double back they do the exact same thing. Good call out from Sentinels. I mean, this is the hardest of reads,
Dapper.
But oh, that Hunter Sphere would have
That's
had
huge.
Been big, but there you go. Dapper, he's been ready for this play for a while.
Oh, no
huge
way.
Shot, huge shot again. The headshots come in swinging, but Shut Up somehow is still alive. He's trying to shut down the Killjoy, and indeed he will. The lockdown goes down, but even then, Shut Up still has a 1v1. It was pure chaos for a couple of seconds there. Oh. And with that flick, 14 seconds left to plant. We'll be able to go down, and it's going to be essentially a full retake now for the Sentinel squad. Not essentially, but absolutely speaking. So, chemicals, he should have gotten that second kill.
They have numbers.
1,000%, but even then, Sentinels still trying to make their way through. Oh boy, three over towards the top area. Shazam's going to be able to get the kill back.
Here.
Slow and steady now, Ito. The plant will eventually getting defused, but there you go. No. The nano swarm ends up going off, but now there's only one person remaining in that smoke. Shazam just goes in with a right. Oh, wow.
That's going to be a shock for Bat Kitchen.
Maybe
felt a bit preemptive.
No way.
Because Shazam is going to be able to easily bounce around it. Of course.
Okay.
That's Sentinels. The innovators, man. Unbelievable.
Yeah, the innovators.
Well, never mind.
Always finding different ways to die.
I was going to say that.
That's just brutal. That's just it's a little bit too insulting. But in we go. Sentinels, no. They've been definitely on the front lines of the last couple of rounds and can't really say much about it. If anything, it's just mounting so much pressure on this Immortals team to just make these takes so much quicker. And again, that's what ended up isolating their players, at least early on in this round. Shazam still taking down Nature. There was another person rotating back. And with 50 seconds left, Immortals have no control.
No control and not even the players to try to get back that control. It seems that they want to finish up towards A here, but when they even get that spike down, their options remain pretty scarce. They have the recon dart off of cooldown at this point, and they're probably going to try to toss the spike over to their jet because that way you can get another point closer to their ultimate, but that's not even going to be the thing that's on your mind building up those ultimates. It's how can we even up these numbers? They've cut noise once more. Again, the Immortals classic, but time is of the essence. They need to move, and they need to move right now. It's not going to be possible. Sentinels are more than ready. They rotated before they even entered towards A main. And it'll be over in a flash. Sentinels now on 9.
Try different things. They all boost their way over towards mid.
Wait a second.
Okay, actually shot. I'm taking down Sig.
Wait.
And the Stingers, they're starting to work. Again, Immortals with an absolute curveball still taking over mid. No one even going over towards bathrooms.
No.
And instead, the Stingers, they're all just working on their favor. Shut up. All alone.
It's flawless.
It's a flawless in more defaulty positions. Maintain lurks
here. Hunter's Fury used, maybe a zoning ult if nothing else.
Ooh.
And that'll be the punishment that we've been looking for from Sentinels. Sick gets the opener. Look at what happens next here. Immortals, this is usually when they kind of calm down the pace a little bit. What I think they're going to do here is completely cut noise, hide as much as they can, and then re-exec A, because this is usually the sign where Immortals start bringing it over towards B. And look, the rotations are already coming in effect. Sentinels, they fell for this one hook, line, and sinker. A little bit more time off the clock, and Immortals should have this site for basically free. This is so well played by Immortals. Plus, they have the lockdown just to really rub salt in the wound.
You should run.
All right.
Should indeed run over to the other side of the map. Sentinels, that's where everything's going to be taking place. They have lockdown too. Keep that in mind.
Absolutely, that lockdown. 30 seconds left. At least for the guys of Sentinels, they know that this is a must-win round. Must-win ulti to pull up, but no way. No way. Shazam, the rare miss. And just like that, this round is more than ready to be taken by Immortals. Two players remaining now for Sentinels, trying to make their way on site. Chemicals, he gets himself another, and not only that, but the knives get pulled out for the third.
King the pace on this attacking side. You have to have high hopes for them. As we look to start things out here, Immortals immediately just want to burst it up over towards B. Okay, simple as that. Get the spike down, play post plant. Sick will try to punish that with a move out through garage, but he's only going to find the one kill, and he backs out safely.
Dapper?
Numbers traded back, and Dapper is already in for the fight. What in the world is going on here from Sentinels?
Yeah, it was just confusing for Dapper, but everyone else on Sentinels, they had full control. So at this point, still two players from Immortals over towards mid. Nature, he on the setup for Sentinels is very much A-based with fast rotations coming in towards this area.
And fast kills right behind it. Immortals have traded even so far. Great double peek out to try to trade the numbers. And it's doing the trick. This is an eco up mine. And yet they've made it so close. 1v1. And it will end with a whimper. Not a
really impressive. But again, Sentinels still trying to put on a little bit of pressure early on to the choke points, but Immortals, they slip on by the defense in a sense. A couple of players out garage, but wow.
Oh, God.
That just gets cleaned up on the C site. Two players make their way.
By a crazy shock dart lineup or anything similar to that. Counter smokes will go through as soon as they hear noise from Immortals, but I don't think it's going to be enough to stop the inevitable push through. That's a huge kill for Shot to immediately find, but once again, trades are so strong from Sentinels. They keep the man advantage, even if it is just by a hair or two. There it is, the spike indeed does get planted, and the punishment for it is going to be lackluster, non-existent. Now Immortals need to find this next kill. What should they do? Back evened up here, not mind.
Evened up, shot up on the front lines. Not only that, but the Empress of Darkness is looking to strike, but oh no, he's getting chased. Wonderfully looked out though. He barely escapes that scenario with Dapper. Towards mid for the Immortals team, but this could be off time.
So good.
But Chemicals does get it onto six. So there you go. That's at least an opening back, but still barely any information in a sense, but Gangsta, he might have just single-handedly opened up that C site, or if anything, gotten up some noise. Instead, now Immortals, they're still putting onto that A site. And look at this off position. Wait a minute. It's a one-and-done position, of course, but Zoms might only need one. There's nobody else over the world long. He's going to readjust. Shazam is here on the rotation. Of course, the plant will be able to go down, but Zoms is still over towards long. They need at least some sort of coverage, and the two-man advantage for Immortals has evaporated. Oh, no. Wait. Chemicals. He's about to flank on both players. Going to be able to get one. Make it two. Massive for Chemicals. But Zoms, the man who was in the one and done, he's not exactly done just yet. Making his way up long. Chemicals trying to get the frag, but a headshot onto him. That's massive for the damage. That's massive for the round. Can't especially if Zoms can get this last one. But there you go. Immortals. Right.
Again, it's a gamble that they're taking here. Impress me once, do it again. That's the start you want, and the start that you absolutely need. Zoms is not nearly going to have the space or positioning to try to at least relay some information to his team. At least Shazam makes up for it, though, beaming one through the smoke. But we have ourselves another really weird situation here, where it's going to be a 4v4 post plant. So much utility still in play.
So much utility, but even then, Immortals, they have the positions right for it. There you go. Double dink onto Shazam, but there's still an explosion out from Dapper and Sinatra. Chemicals is there, though, with a double. Now in comes Sinatra to jump the on in. Oh, absolutely. And looks like Sentinels, they're ready for it in terms of manpower. And Sick, more importantly, that's a 3k farm. Megan up north, one more remaining along. Sick can get the ice, but Gangsta, such a sticky scenario. And he is not done yet. Okay, even the shock dart's not going to take him down. 14 HP left on Gangsta. He has the classic out. Everyone else is jumping. Sentinels.
Back almost entirely likely. Unless this shorty can prove to be lethal. Good smoke too to try to help Chemicals get out, but it's such a just well-placed molly where there's just no option to get out for free.
Nature!
What the hell, nature?
There you go!
A freak of nature, dude!
Absolutely!
How can you just do that?
I mean, you gotta be joking me with that one. So, Nature, again, he ends up catching one player who is still checking his angles. And not only that, but the double right clicks work on his favor.
No way!
Gangsta now with another one. Still around the corner. Shazam has a whole lot of HP. Nature has to back on out. He has full control of the spike. 50 seconds left. More than enough time for Shazam to really reapproach this one. But Nature, again, like I mentioned before, this impact fragger, this new blood, this absolute legend could definitely pull it off. Spots a pixel. Right below the smoke, but now the spike will be able to get taken off that cage from Nature. And no rotation either. Shazam is going to go for this, but it's not planted for him. Not planted for Nature, at least.
Oh, they're going to fight long? Oh, no, he's doubling back.
Oh, Nature was going to fight up long, still thinking about it. Again, Shazam, one bullet will do it. A gust of wind will do it. And Nature is going to get taken down, but great stuff from Nature. Still holding up that.
Realize what they're going to be up against here. Sure, they're both even on rifles, but that means that they're just going to try to push in immediately. Fight blood for blood, fire with fire, and try to get it done right here. You don't want to have this be as even as you can. But once again, Immortals show up with the theatrics as they pull off four kills in the matter of five to finish it up. Immortals, they're very, very good at. There's been a couple of scary instances where Chemicals has pushed into smokes, but he has done it with such poise, and it's so calculated, and he was almost thinking about doing it again. Actually, it was JC Stanny who was thinking about doing it again, but just layers upon layers of executes and frags. Immortals stay strong in this round. Sentinels on the back foot.
Last Sentinel's on the back foot. Zom still certainly getting a whole lot of damage over towards the mid side. Zom, if he certainly wanted to, could get a little bit of a spam, and indeed he does, but it's a little bit off put. Instead, it's going to be Gangsta at the end with a kill onto Zom's. Only two frags.
Strike.
Oh, JC Stanny getting banged out by the shock darts, but even then, there's still attention for Immortals for the retake back. There you go, shot up off the Empress. Gonna be able to get two, make it three. Oh. No, Sick gets it back. Still looking over towards the smoke. Chemicals with the updraft gets one. No, it's Zom's. Oh, there you go. Zom's after a
moment. He feels at least somewhat justified in taking. He goes down very low HP, and that will prompt Sick to push in with his run it back. Gets one kill, and that is going to be the finish on the Chemicals. And there it is, appearing in the kill feed over and over. It will be Sentinels. There is a bit of a strike back from Shotup, who gets two. The round's not done yet. Immortals still have some fight in them yet.
Gangsta needed that shock dart. At least an opportunity for at least a little bit of damage through that smoke, but now it's a little bit tighter because Sick now has a very optimal angle off of a crossfire too in hell. Not only that, but there's a player just focused up on heaven. Dapper waiting up for a dart, but instead it is going to be Gangsta that comes out.
Start pushing through, and this is usually when they find a couple of free frags, so they'll bring it towards C, and this will be a lot more of a palatable situation for them, because they only allow Gangsta to find one, and they're able to take fights at their own volition. Maybe JC Stanny has something to say about it up mind.
Well, certainly so. Still up on the front lines, it's actually going to be Nature with that first frag, or at least with that first drop. Now 3-on-2 for Sentinels. They turn to man disadvantage to an advantage, but now in comes Shotup with a frag. He's going to be able to dismiss, but Sinatra gets the kill back. Make it a third for Sinatra. So there you go, Immortals. Down with a little bit of split, although, again, their economy is a little bit effective. Oh my god. Although it is a little bit ineffective, ultimately, if they do get into these tight battles that Immortals are wanting to take. But in we go. Sinatra actually with a classic, able to combine with his teammates to take down JC Stanny. But Gangsta with a hit and run snags one back. So not with a 4-on-4, and Zom still on the lurk at least. There's still a little bit of a chance to create some space, but he ends up getting spotted out. So still Sentinels, no contact, no control just yet, but this A-site might be their best option. There's barely any util, and this one contact and cat could really open things out if they can win it over Chemicals.
Quiet for now. Chemicals, is he one to give up a frag like that? He's already put up his Bladestorm and then some as well. Kind of overdoing it if you want a Bladestorm to play with your Chemicals.
He's still going.
Himself, dude. 30 seconds
left. He's still going. This man is at least bloodthirsty. He's looking at stat pad. I mean, he saw us talking about players with 40 bombs and whatnot. He wants to be a part of that club, to say the least. He starts off the game with an absolute banger, almost reaching double. Same thing with Immortals. This is a round-defining battle. And JC Stanny at least is going to win the next one out. Chemicals on his own.
Amazing.
Gets another one. So there you go. Like I said, round defining is now Immortals. They have more control. And Sentinels, they start to get desperate and hold their way forward. Still Dapper remaining in a 1v3. This man, again, has been an absolute legend for Sentinels in the past in terms of clutches. And he could do it again. You know, only has really one angle to watch after this one. Nature misses on the spray, but pulls out the frenzy, the sidearms of information. But Sentinels, they still have players around to try to help out off the take. And there you go. Shazam starts things off with a kill onto Chemicals, just beaming through the smoke. Still Immortals has one in the back lines. Nature has to hold things down essentially on his lonesome, but never mind. Immortals, they have stairs control. And now Dapper is down to a 1v2 once again. And this time he has the full positional control and time on his hands. He's out of there.
But you have to remember, only Stinger in his grasp right now. Sure, he'll have the entire site to himself, but he still needs to try to continue to innovate after he gets this one planted. Nature is bleeding internally, low on HP, only 8 to his name. So that makes it a lot more comfortable for the Stinger. But as the spike gets planted, Dapper will probably now remain in his camera position. He has a nice amount of HP, where he can probably, if nothing else, try to, I don't know, optimize his position, but surely Immortals trade themselves out here. Well, they even spot the camera as well. This is going to be huge for Dapper. Got to be huge.
Oh, absolutely. That's Very much a one and done angle, but still so much space to actually work with. I mean, it's almost impossible that anyone would check this, but Immortals are still saying very wary. There you go. Dapper gets the pick for a gamble rotate back over towards A, or at least some of the players have abandoned control, and there's only one player on site for them to clear out. And Chemicals is actually here to try to help out. One up close, it's gonna be Sinatra. Gangsta now with a Hunter Sphere gonna try to help out. Nature still in the back of sight, like I mentioned before.
Wait a second.
Is Sinatra doing? Still going out forward right into the rotating hands of Immortals, but that's big from Sick. One last person remaining, it is Gangsta, who ended up getting himself a frag with that Hunter Sphere, and he's the lone man with a stinger. He has a mission, though. Immortals. It would be a massive win for the team going forward, but Gangsta now knows that there's one at least up close. That Shock Dart not exactly going to connect all that deep, but he's still going to have to clear out that angle. Spike taking down little by little. And no bullets. He's surely biding his time for a player that just has to get a 1v2 over with, but Sick has the angle anyways. He's still going to get banged out early, and not only that, but it has to be a full retake, isn't it? With the smoke up, and Sick actually getting exposed. Whoa, wait a minute. And not only that, but the lockdown early on. It gets pulled out, and Sentinels, they're not even abandoning. They're still fighting this with Sinatra. He's going to get stuck in this, and they know that he's here. He was the one that just pulled out the darts. There's a couple of players over towards main two, and there you go.
What?
Hole. He has the Odin combo through the wall. Gonna be able to get a little bit of damage in two. Shut up, waiting for a player to swing out, and instead he forces out the interaction. First bullet right off of the swing, and he's able to get the kill from it. Sick with a fake Rolling Thunder, and Nature with a flick back, able to hold back on towards the cat side. Still two more players here, and JC Stanny comes in essentially out of nowhere off the rotate. And Sick, I mean, he could have definitely used that Rolling Thunder for the A take. He used it for a fake instead, and Chemicals off the jump.
No dart needed, and it's still huge. Shot up. He has to not be caught out of position here, but he is. It all is going to come down to Gangsta to hold the line. No, there's already a push through from JC Stanny. Again, the calculated aggression. The gunfights need to go their way here on mine. And they are!
Unreal. Again, Sentinels, again, they wanted early pressure over towards that back spawn entrance of B, but it didn't work out in their favor. So instead now, it's Sinatra, the legend here for Sentinels, to try to hold back the line. He's in a 1v2, he has an Odin, and he's gonna go down! No way! Nature peeks on out. Sentinels, they have a 68% round win rate here on the defensive side of Ascent thus far in this tournament, and they don't want to let go of this lockjaw hold of this B site. What a rotation, what a hold. Everyone from Immortals, they fuck sites. Essentially playing anti-flash and anti-take most likely. But in we go.
What is
Sinatra,
this?
There you go, what a jump. Against the pistols, they got no chance. Massive read from Sentinels, but Immortals making their way through. They're making it entertaining. Shot up, gonna get one back. Oh, Shazam, he absolutely needed one back, but Shot up all by himself. He's the instigator, he's the fragger. He gets himself three, and now Sentinels left on the back foot with only two players once again. Hello, Sick, though, gets a little bit more damage. Sinatra, this is now possible. 150 now in terms of HP. He can still approach, getting blasted through the smoke still. Gets the kill back onto JC Stanny. Relatively low HP on the other one, but this is still very much an even 1v1. Sinatra, we saw him with an opportunity for a 2v1 earlier. He could succeed now. Finds the player. He's actually going to pull out the op. Hello, Bogdan's log. Does he pull it off? Jumping in! What on earth was that kill? Does he have time? Oh, indeed he does! That's amazing from Sinatra! Unreal!
Fury, surely.
I'm gonna counteract you here. Nature, he's one away from actually picking up the lockdown, so who knows at this point what could be pulled off, but again, unbelievably speaking, you still have that op back. For Shazam still ringing out true, but oh man, look at the amount of damage being done. Sinatra already down to one from that nano swarm. Now that again, very deep nano swarm, and it ends up hitting at the right time. And now Sentinels,
now they have the lockdown
down to a 2-on-3, and indeed they do. The lockdown's about to go down as Nature He's going to restrict these Sentinels players to commit, actually. They're still going for this. One in short.
The aftershock is huge.
The aftershock's not going to hit, though. That was so close. So close to actually hitting that lockdown, though. What a great idea, but it doesn't connect. Now it's a 2-on-2, though, with Sick taking out Chemicals. Watch out for JC standing on the front lines right behind the smoke. The two players might actually be backing out, though, with time ticking away, and they're looking for the exits off this crossfire. That's a very good idea. One enemy remaining.
They can find all the kills they want, but this round is Immortals. I just cannot more to play with. Hunter's Fury is going to be the first of the tools of the trade.
Oh, but Chemicals out for blood again, this time looking for a double kill, but that's a massive Rolling Thunder that doesn't connect. That's a shut up, and he's safe. Gangsta is here to help out too. How on earth did they survive that entire onslaught?
Even with the knives, their best chance yet, they get taken down by Chemicals.
What on earth is this? No, you would never even expect one person to be here. They actually have two for the double coverage.
This could be
massive for a couple of racks.
They're checking.
Wait, what? Why would you ever check that angle? I would be molding right now if I were Sick. Who would ever check that angle? That is insane. 4v2 now. Sinatra takes that one in terms of shot up. And I don't know what to think anymore. Chemicals now gonna be able to get yet another one for his kill tally. And for a moment there, and they're actually gonna maintain a fast rotation to that cat area. Everyone's just watching the mid rotation, but wow, Chemicals takes down Sinatra. That's one down for Sentinels. There's one here on site. Oh, Zoms can't get it back and turn to the teleport. That's all the information in the world. Chemicals with another one takes down Zoms. Sentinels, with only three players remaining, need to somehow make their way back on site. Now, no chance. Chemicals, JC Stanny, both get their kills. Shazam now has to be the hero with the 1v5. He's gotta go for it. Sentinels, they're hounding for this one. Immortals, look at the players starting to rack up. They even have util to spend. Even an Empress of Darkness. And through the shadows, Shazam emerges. Still trying to get a couple of frags. Still trying to get anything. He's overwhelmed. Immortals, they've done it. They beat Sentinels 2-1. And they're on.